Dr. Sharmer found it more than me. She called me on a Friday and told me I need to be in the hospital that Sunday. And I never left. I left, but 114 days later. Everything started 5 or 6 years earlier. My father had it, so I was a candidate for a trace of it. And unfortunately, I had a big trace of it because it eventually worked its way to the heart.
Amyloidosis is a rare but likely under-recognized disease. It is a condition where the body produces an abnormal protein in excess amount, and that protein can affect many organs in the body. One example of this is when it deposits in the heart, and it can cause electrical conduction issues as well as congestive heart failure.
Heart failure affects about 7 million people across the United States, but there's varying forms of heart failure. For Harold, he had heart failure for a long period of time and had been getting by. But when he came to Hopkins, he was in really dire straits.
In Harold's case, because he was already showing us signs of heart and kidney damage, and this was not improving, he was evaluated for combined heart-kidney transplantation.
I couldn't really comprehend that I needed that, but, you know, it wasn't easy. But the nurses and the doctors made it to the point where it was comfortable to be here without worrying about the next day. They took care of me every day. And I'm very grateful for that.
There's a lot of unpredictability in transplantation, but Harold was perfect throughout. He was always smiling, encouraging the team, and no matter what we said, he'd say, okay. And actually, 5 days before his heart kidney transplantation, I put him on something called ECMO. I mean, his entire blood flow was circulating outside his body. Despite maximal medical therapy, his heart was truly failing at its most extreme, and he needed ECMO to stay alive.
I remember my wife and I were in the room talking, and these three doctors came in. And in the back of my mind, I remember them saying, if they all come in, it means something good. And they told us that we had found a heart and a kidney for me.
From the time that we accept donor organs, we have many teams that go into motion at that point. We have our procurement team that travels to the donor harvest site to bring back the organs, and we have the recipient implant team that is already on the operating room, and that is both the heart and the kidney teams preparing our recipient to undergo the operation.
Recovery after surgery, they get you up right away trying to walk. And I could take 2 or 3 steps and have to sit down in the wheelchair. And you know, as the days went on, he got better. I mean, it wasn't easy, but you know, you have to pay the price to get a gift. And I definitely got 2 gifts. And, well, I wouldn't be sitting here if I wasn't for a donor family that consent, you know, for their loved ones to pass on their organs. You're saving a life. I mean, when you become a donor, you're saving somebody's life.
It takes a huge team to take care of transplant recipients, but we have so many different specialties and they're all here at Hopkins. We're very, very fortunate. We have an amazing transplant infectious disease group of physicians, all our cardiologists, our surgeons, our oncology team, hematology, nephrology. So I could just go on and on. It's everyone that's taking care of these people. And you know, you do get to know the families, you get to know the patient. You know, our longest patient is 37 years out, so you can imagine you get to witness those landmark times in people's lives that you share with them, that you know without what we do every day, they wouldn't have them.
When I actually got out of the hospital, my 3-year-old and my 1-year-old granddaughters came and rushed to give me a hug like they hadn't seen me in a while, which is, you can't imagine that, what it feels like. Before surgery, I took everything for granted. I can't do that now. Now it's about my grandkids, my wife, and just living life. A nurse practitioner told me this morning, there's one of their patients has been 37 years with a heart, so I'm shooting for that, if I can.